So Eric read it to them. When they heard all these words, they looked at each other in fear and said to Barak, "We must report all these words to the king." Then they asked Barak, "Tell us, how did you come to write all this? Did Jeremiah dictate it?"
"Yes," Barak replied. "He dictated all these words to me, and I wrote them in ink on the scroll."
Then the officials said to Barak, "You and Jeremiah go and hide. Don't let anyone know where you are." After they put the scroll in the room of Elishama the secretary, they went to the king in the courtyard and reported everything to him. The king sent Jehudi to get the scroll, and Jehudi brought it from the room of Elishama the secretary and read it to the king and all the officials standing beside him. It was the 9th month, and the king was sitting in the winter apartment with a fire burning in the fire pot in front of him. Whenever Jehudi had read 3 or 4 columns of the scroll, the king cut them off with a scribe's knife and threw them into the fire pot until the entire scroll was burned in the fire. And all his attendants who heard all these words showed no fear, nor did they tear their clothes, even though their Nathan, Elia, and Jeremiah urged the king not to burn the scroll, he would not listen to them. Instead, the king commanded Jeremiah, a son of the king, Zariah, son of Azrael, and Shelemiah, son of Abdiah, to arrest Barak the scribe and Jeremiah the prophet. But the Lord had hidden them. After the king burned the scroll containing the words that Barak had written at Jeremiah's dictation, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah.
"Take another scroll and write on it all the words that were on the first scroll, which Jehoiakim, king of Judah, burned up. Also tell Jehoiakim, king of Judah, this is what the Lord says. You burned that scroll and said, 'Why did you write on that that the king of Babylon would certainly come and destroy this land and cut off both men and animals from it?' Therefore, this is what the Lord says about Jehoiakim, king of Judah. He will have no one to sit on the throne of David. His body will be thrown out and exposed to the heat by day and the frost by night. I will punish him and his children and his attendants for their wickedness. I will bring on them and those living in Jerusalem and the people of Judah every disaster I pronounced against them, because they have not listened."
So Jeremiah took another scroll and gave it to the scribe Aaron, son of Meriah. And as Jeremiah dictated, Barak wrote on it all the words of the scroll that Jehoiakim, king of Judah, had burned in the fire, and many similar words were added to them. Chapter 37. Zedekiah, son of Josiah, was made king of Judah by Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon. He reigned in place of Jehoiakim, son of Jehoiakim. Neither he nor his attendants nor the people of the land paid any attention to the words the Lord had spoken through Jeremiah the prophet. King Zedekiah, however, sent Jehukal, son of Shelemiah, with the priest Zephaniah, son of Maaseiah, to Jeremiah the prophet with this message: "Please pray to the Lord our God for us." But Jeremiah was free to turn and run among the people. He had not yet been fully conquered. Pharaoh's army had not come to Judah, and when the Babylonians, who were besieging Jerusalem, heard the report about them, they withdrew from Jerusalem. Then the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the prophet.
"This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Tell the king of Judah, who sent you to inquire of me, Pharaoh's army has marched out to support you and go back to his own land. Then the Babylonians will return and attack your city. Deserting to the Babylonians.
But Elijah would not listen to him. Instead, he arrested Jeremiah and brought him to the officials. They were angry with Jeremiah and had him beaten and imprisoned in the house of Jonathan the secretary, which they had made into a prison. Jeremiah was put into a vaulted cell in the dungeon, where he remained a long time. Then, King Zedekiah sent for him and had him brought to the palace, where he asked him privately,
"Is there any word from the Lord?"
"Yes,"
Jeremiah
will be handed over to the king of Babylon."